Hi, and welcome back for another Whimsy Stamps card. We're going to be making this slimline shaker card, and I'm super excited to share with you how I created my own little shaker bits using the brand new Space Minions die set from Whimsy Stamps. We're also going to be using the Lost in Space slimline paper pack, the slimline observation deck die, and our black hole clear stamps for a sentiment. So the first thing I'm going to do is grab out my Shrinky Dinks paper. It's plastic, and it has two sides, a shiny side and a more rough side. And I am going to die cut these with my Gemini Junior, which adds a ton of pressure, but as you can see, it still doesn't cut all the way through the plastic because, again, it is a piece of plastic. It's not paper. So I'm going to try and run it through a second time, but honestly, it doesn't cut it out either, and it makes the plastic a little more breakable, if that's the right word. The little antenna got a little weak. So if you try this out yourself, I would just run it once through your die cutting machine and trim it out. And it's really easy. You're just following the path and it cuts very easily because it's already kind of semi-cut from the steel die. So I am just going to trace the outline of the die and make sure I'm being very careful around my little alien antenna here because they were a little weaker, and just cut it out. And I am going to leave the eyes inside because I'm just going to be coloring it instead of, you know, die cutting and paper piecing. So once I have one of those cut, I'm going to cut all three of them. And now I have all four. I'm going to be using my Spectrum Noir alcohol markers, and I'm being very careful when I'm coloring this because the ink does stay wet, and I'm coloring on the more the not the shiny side, the rougher side, and just adding color to my alien. I decided to go with a fun green color, and I also am going to use black inside of the eyes. And the reason why I'm using my alcohol markers is because these are the only markers I have. If you have, you know, permanent markers, that's probably a little better. It's still alcohol ink, but it's a more of a permanent, like a Sharpie. I would definitely use those instead, but I'm just using what I have, and that's okay. I'm showing you that it will absolutely work if you only have alcohol markers too. So I laid down two layers of color for the green because it is light, but it will shrink and brighten up in color. So now I have warmed up my embossing tool here, and I'm using my tweezers, and as you can see, it's really quick. You have to hold on to that guy or it will fly everywhere. And I use my tweezers just to kind of help keep it in place. And because I preheat my embossing gun here, my machine, embossing gun, my heater, I think it's called an embossing gun, because I preheat it warmed up and melted my little guys super quickly. And I was really happy with how it turned out, so I went ahead and colored the rest. And instead of paper, I'm just using a silicone mat here. You want something that the plastic won't stick to as it gets hot. And I'm going to use my tweezers again to hold it. I've preheat my heat tool. That's a better word for it. I read it off the picture here. My heat tool. And once I got it warmed up and going, you can see it melted and it looked great. But then I was squeezing the neck for too long trying to share it on the camera, and my poor little alien's neck is a little squished. Okay, third time's a charm here. I'm going to use my tweezers to hold it down. I'm not holding onto the antenna. I'm not going to squeeze it. I have my heat gun all ready to go. And the thing about Shrinky Dinks is they will curl up as they melt. That's completely normal. Just keep that heat on there and they will flatten out. Now, the little alien obviously shrunk very quickly because it was so tiny, but it's the cutest one. So now I have all four. You can see how tiny they get and how fun and what great little shaker bits they're going to be. And this is actually the shiny side up now. And don't they look so cute? So I'm going to do this again three more times, and I have a total of 12 little Shrinky Dink aliens to put into my shaker card. So now let's work on actually putting the card together. So I have two sheets of the Lost in Space slimline paper, but I'm only going to use one. I wasn't sure how it was going to look when I cut out this row of kind of pink craters on our planet here out of the paper. I was worried that I wouldn't have enough of the blue because I cut it in half. You'll see in a second. So I'm like, maybe I need to layer, but I really like the contrast of the pink with the purple and blue behind it. And I thought, you know what? I did die cut this other piece of starry paper from the paper pack using the Slimline Observation Deck Die, and it's smaller than the paper. So I can layer these two, and my front piece here will be on the front of the shaker, and my blue piece will be on the back of the shaker, and they're going to overlap enough that you won't see that I actually cut this paper to create my two different layers. I hope that made sense. As you watch the video, you'll see what I do, and it will hopefully make sense. So I lined the back of my observation deck cutout with some double-sided adhesive, and I am layering my pink craters here on the back of that paper. So that's going to be the front of my shaker, and I'm going to put more sticky tape on the back of that crater piece, and I'm going to follow along the edge of my craters here, and then I'm going to put a piece of acetate behind this. So this is the top of my shaker. This is the part where I'm going to be gluing my details at the end to, and my acetate's going to go behind it. So I have this large piece of acetate, and I'm just going to use my scissors here to trim where I need to cut it on my paper trimmer. So I know it needs to be just a little bit smaller than the width and length of my front part of my shaker here. And now that it's cut out, I can go ahead and adhere this to the back. I was making sure it will fit and it looks good. So I can layer that on after I pull up all of that release paper from my double-sided tape and adhere that acetate down. Okay, so now I have the front of my shaker. It's time to move on to the next piece. Here you can see I'm just double checking to make sure that I can layer that blue piece behind and it will look okay, and it does, and I'm really happy I can just keep using the same piece of paper. So just like I did with the acetate, I am trimming it down so that way I know how to trim it on my paper trimmer, just kind of using my eyes and best guessing my cuts, which probably isn't the safest, measure twice, cut once kind of thing, but it worked out for this card. So now I need to work on the shaker part, and I decided to cut a second piece of acetate to sandwich my shaker together with acetate, and that way I wouldn't have to worry about trying to layer everything together with that blue paper and then my card base. This is just an easy way to make sure that my shaker bits will stay where I want them when I'm adhering the shaker mechanism part to my card base. So I have outlined all three of my windows using some extra thick foam tape, and I am going to put one of each different type of alien in each window. I have these kind of multicolored star glitter sequins-y kind of pieces I thought would be really fun to put on this card since it is kind of an outer space theme. And then I have these clear seed beads that I'm putting into each of the windows just to help move those sequins and my little aliens around. I'm going to carefully peel off all of the release paper from my foam tape, and once that is done, I'll take that second piece of acetate and sandwich all of those shaker bits inside. Now I'm going to press really hard and make sure there's really good adhesion on my acetate to the foam strips, and there we have our shaker bits. And I think that one little alien that I accidentally squeezed his neck too tight kind of got stuck. So I'm opening up my window and trying to shove that little alien back down to hide behind the craters, and that alien might just be stuck there forever. I don't know. It's okay though. So now everything is looking pretty good. I'm going to go ahead and work on the back side of my shaker, so what will be adhered to my card base. So I'm using that double-sided tape again and outlining the back and placing that onto my blue sky piece. It's a little long. I misjudged where to cut it, so I'm just going to trim off a little bit more and adhere that down. And then I also need to put a card base together. So after I check and I'm super happy with how my shaker is turning out, I'm going to go ahead and cut out a card base. I'm just going to line the bottom with some double-sided sticky tape so everything is ready to adhere to the base. I went through my stash and picked various colors, and I decided to go with this kind of bright neon-y purple. I thought it matched really well with the planet craters. I added wet glue to the paper part of the back here because I already have that sticky tape on the rest, and adhered that down to my card base, and I'm just really enjoying how this card is turning out. I think it's so cute. So to decorate the front of the card, I decided to use that same pink purpley paper, and I die cut all four of my little aliens. So there, that die is one die. So if you just put it through one time, you're going to get your four aliens. And then I took a scrap from cutting out the window part of my observation deck die of that starry, kind of black starry paper. I'm trimming it to be the eyes of my cute little aliens. So I just eyeballed and trimmed so that would fit perfectly behind my alien and cover the eyes, and then use some wet glue to adhere that on the back side. And there we have our fun little alien, and he has starry eyes just out there looking at space. I wanted to add some shadow, so I grabbed one of my alcohol markers in a purple violet that I thought matched the paper really well, and just going around and adding a little bit of detail so my alien looks a little more 3D and not so flat looking. I'm going to repeat this for all four of my aliens, and then now I'm going to start putting it together and creating my layout. So I'm playing around with the placement of my four little aliens, and I think they're just looking real cute on my card. And I want my aliens to have a comic bubble coming out and putting on a sentiment from that black hole stamp set. So I originally thought I was going to do a dual layer here and say birthday greetings from outer space, but I didn't want to block the window. I was afraid that you wouldn't get as much fun if I was blocking the window with a whole sentiment. So I went with a single little bubble here. It's going to come out of my little alien, and I'm going to just stamp birthday greetings. I just think that is cute and to the point, and will be great for this card without blocking the window too much. So I went ahead and die cut it out of white paper and stamped it in some black ink. And now I'm just going to use my wet glue to adhere that down to my card. Because I have acetate, I just want to make sure it's nice and secure. And then I'm going to glue the rest of my aliens down. So just adding a little bit of wet glue and putting them back right where I had planned to put them. And there we go, our finished card. I'm going to slow it down so you can check out this shaker in full effect and see how fun those little green aliens and stars come up when you shake the card. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, I hope you'll click that like button. And if you're new here to the channel, I really hope you'll subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. You can use the links down below to check out all of the Whimsy Stamps goodies used on this card. Also, you can find links down below to the social media sites for Whimsy Stamps where you can find even more inspiration. Thanks for watching. Bye.